Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Dinosaur Channel. This is your home on the internet for all things dinosaur and prehistoric. I'm your host, Tall, and today we're going to be covering the Elasmotherium. This is going to be our first non-dinosaur, non-reptile. This is so exciting. But before you do, make sure you subscribe and turn on those notifications so you don't miss any new quick dives on these prehistoric creatures that we do in the future. Also, please leave us a dino-sized thumbs up and comment down below a dinosaur or prehistoric creature that you would like to see us cover in the future. So that being said, let's ram our horns right into the magnificent Elasmotherium. The name Elasmotherium means thin plate breast. This creature is also known as the woolly rhino, the Siberian unicorn, the steppe rhinoceros. Wait, what? That's not a dinosaur. Actually, guys, today we're not going to talk about a dinosaur at all. We're going to be talking about a prehistoric mammal. This beast was the last surviving member of Elasmotherinae, a distinctive group of large rhinoceros separate but still related to modern rhinoceroses. Or rhinoceroses? I don't really know how to say it. Okay, so where and when did the Elasmotherium live? This amazing animal lived on the Eurasian grasslands, ranging from southwestern Russia and Ukraine to Kazakhstan and Siberia. Actually, the woolly rhino lived during the Ice Age in the late Miocene epoch, through the Pleistocene epoch of the Cenozoic era. This was about 2 million years to around 39,000 years ago. The Elasmotherium went extinct during the Pleistocene megafaunal extinction event, where hundreds of large mammal species were wiped off the face of the Earth. This happened sometime around 50,000 to 5,000 years ago. This mass extinction could have been caused by climate changing, vegetation, and human hunting. So this animal would have been sharing Eurasia with both modern humans and Neanderthals, but paleobiologist Professor Adrian Lister explains that it's unlikely that Elasmotherium was hunted into extinction, since there's no archaeological association of this animal with people in any way at any sites known so far. So what did the Elasmotherium actually look like? This gigantic creature reached up to at least 16 feet or 5 meters long, over 6 feet or 2 meters tall, and an estimated 11,000 to 13,000 pounds or 5 to 6,000 kilograms. That's huge. It was literally among the largest in the rhino family, second to Paraceratheum. Paraceratheum? I really don't know how to pronounce this one. This was comparable in size to the woolly mammoth, and larger than the contemporary woolly rhinoceros, Coelodonta. The Elasmotherium is thought to have a keratinous horn. So you might be wondering, what is keratin? Keratin is the type of protein that makes up your hair, skin, and nails. It's also the key structural material to making up scales, feathers, horns, claws, hooves, and the outer layers of skin among vertebrates. Now, the base of the Elasmotherium's horn sits up to 5 inches deep in the forehead. It could grow up to 3 feet or 90 centimeters in circumference, and a little less than 5 feet or 1.5 meters long. That's as large as me, that's crazy! And there was likely a large hump of muscle on the back, which is generally thought to have supported this heavy horn. Now, while this Ice Age giant is usually reconstructed as a woolly beast with thick, shaggy fur, it's sometimes depicted as bare-skinned like modern rhinos. Just imagine a white rhinoceros the size of an African elephant with a large freaking hump on the back and a huge horn. So is it possible that early humans who lived alongside this strange beast may have been inspired to create the legend of the unicorn? Don't ask me. I don't know. I'm uninvolved. Now, is the Elasmotherium famous? Was there any mention of it in popular culture? From all information available online, this beast only made a few appearances. It was featured in the Minecraft mod, Fossils in Archaeology. It also appears in 2 episodes of the British sci-fi drama series, Prehistoric Park. It was also in the video game Jurassic Park Builder as a limited edition herbivore in the Glacier Park. But sadly, Jurassic Park Builder was shut down in March 2020 and is no longer available. Elasmotherium was added to Jurassic World the Game, which is a sequel to Jurassic Park Builder. Also, the Elasmotherium is mentioned in the free-to-play location-based augmented reality game Jurassic World Alive, which we all know and love. Okay, let's move on to the diet and behavior. So, the Elasmotherium was actually herbivorous. This animal is exclusively a grazer and fed almost entirely on grass. And we know that by studying remains of this almost comically heavy, oversized flat teeth and lack of incisors. There are various theories about this animal's morphology and behavior. Some show the beast trotting around like a horse with a horn, others say it hunched over its head to the ground like a bison. And still others say that Elasmotherium would have immersed itself in swamps like a hippopotamus. This was most likely a solitary animal and was highly territorial. Elasmotherium would charge when startled or provoked, impaling its perceived threats with its gigantic horn. You wouldn't want to be caught in a jousting match with this giant beast. And that, my friends, is the Elasmotherium, our first ever non-dinosaur, non-reptile on this channel. If you love this awesome prehistoric creature, then smack us with a dinosaur-sized thumbs up, because we're covering all the animals featured in the Jurassic Park and World franchise. Also subscribe, turn on those notifications so you don't miss a single dinosaur or prehistoric animal quick dive on this channel. And hey, comment down below a dinosaur or prehistoric creature that you would like to see us cover in the next episode. And if you like this channel and you want to support us, then you can send us a donation on PayPal. The link will be down below in the description, and it'll help us keep making videos just like this just for you. Your next creature is going to be the pterodactyl, and we'll see you then. Goodbye!